Hey everyone, it's Wednesday the 4th of October 2017, but 10 o'clock in the morning. I figured I'd kill two birds with one stone and do my abs while I can talk about the Mandalay, if that's the way you say that hotel's name, incident in Vegas. Now, I'm not here to jump on any bandwagons. I mean, it's still fresh, and I've still yet to pour through a whole bunch of information. I mean, you know, look at what's on there now. Multiple shooters, single lone nut, videos of a fourth floor shooter, 32nd floor, this floor, one broken window, two broken windows. You know, it just, there's so much information to go through and reading articles and everything. One thing I do notice is that it doesn't pass the smell test, like the official narrative that's, you know, almost like when 9/11 happened. We had, you know, oh, it's this guy, that, this, and the other, and we have it all. It's all a nice little bundle, and we'll just let it go at that. So, what I do notice right away is in talking to people here in this small town, just this small town of 2,000 people, that the emotion is at an absolute fever pitch. You know, as I was going through videos and all kinds of stuff, I was noticing that it's just an absolute, there's just, the lines are so cemented and fermented that there's no talking to either side. You know, whether you want to call it the gun lovers and the non-gun lovers, we'll just leave it at that. We'll just use that as a very, you know, an A and B kind of thing. What keeps popping into my mind, you know, with the way things have been rolling along in America and the narrative against Donald Trump, and once again, I don't have a horse in the race. I'm a Canadian. All I know about Donald Trump is that, you know, he was an entertainer more than he was a politician, you know? I mean, he might know how to be political because of the, you know, where he's from and what he does, but he's not a career politician, you know. But like I said, I'm not, you know, pro-Hillary or pro-Trump. I'm just looking at the emotion and where we are and where we're going. And what pops into my mind with what's been going on, and I don't know why, but regime change. Regime change in America. And people might say, well, what do you mean regime change? And I'm like, well, you know, in order to protect the, you know, the citizens from themselves, you know, we have to do something because the government's not doing anything. Like, let's just look at Bashar al-Assad, you know, the vilification of Bashar al-Assad. It's the same, you know, we got to go in and save the poor Syrian people from the government because, you know, they don't have a control on blah, 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 and they're doing all the dastardly things. So, you know, and I know that's a real stretch, but if you look about all the color revolutions and the regime change that have happened, they've all been funded from the outside, and it was always for a political reason or a gain or whatever, you know, whether it be to redistribute wealth around the planet or just to change things in general. So when I see what's going on, like, you know, when I look at Iraq, and, you know, we can go back in time and look at all the governmental changes that have happened where we've wanted to have another government in play so that we could do whatever we wanted, and I mean we is the whomever wants to have the control of all the chess pieces, you know, all the pawns. So that's what I take right on. And right now, the reason I say it doesn't pass the smell test is because there's just so many things that need to come out more. You know, I want to see the everything. I want to see all the hotel security footage. You know, because a drunken, gambling alcoholic, in my opinion, in his mid-60s is not going to convert to Islam. You know, I believe Islam is against alcohol and gambling, so that doesn't really quite smell quite true. You know, and whether or not he was Antifa or whatever, Antifa, depending on how you want to say it or whatever, but the emotion is real. Look at what's going on. People are starting to tear each other apart. You know, the big argument that we're having up here is why do civilians need high-powered assault rifles, you know, and as an ex-soldier, you know, I mean, I was in the Navy, albeit, but we did do, you know, rifle shoots. I started with an FN, and then we took over and we went and got the C2, or the C7, or whatever we call it now. I'm confusing my my letters, sorry. I think basically C7, I think, is just a, it's a 5.56, anyway. I think it's standard NATO. But, so, I will be in agreement that, you know, you don't really require a high power, and I don't believe that civilians, untrained civilians, should be running around with battle rifles, you know. But that's an argument for another day. The emotion is real, you know. And another thing I noticed too, as well, is a lot of people are getting confused with terms like false flag, hoax, you know, and stuff like that, and they're thinking that I'm of the opinion. My opinion that people did die. Some, there was shooters, plural. And I can't comment on whether it was organized. There's just not enough information has come out to light right now where I can just say, yeah, it was a lone nut, you know, some disgruntled, you know, whatever, and he just, you know, popped off after drinking, you know, a couple of vodka tonics, and then after gambling or whatever, and he got bored or he lost, you know, at the spinning wheel or whatever, and then he went up and just started shooting up the concert. Just doesn't pass the smell test. So I'm of the opinion that a real event happened. As to who were the perpetrators or what have you, and the actual motivation, you know, do they want a civil war in America? Do we want regime change in America? Is this a, you know, a gun grab, like you'll notice that everybody that's online is saying that, I don't want to smack my head, is, you know, this is like, this is the arguments that are going back and forth, right? It's a gun grab, they're going to try and take our guns, and what really chokes me out is all the comedians that are coming out and using this as a joke platform. You know, I was watching a Colbert video, and they're, you know, talking to some Australian. I don't know if it was a mashup or whatever, but, or Jon Stewart. Anyway, you know, it's not a comedic time. It's not agenda time. Like, you know how people are just gonna run in there, you know, oh, you just had a hurricane. Hey, buy flood insurance from my company or whatever. And it's pretty tragic, but something is obviously in the works. I don't know if this is a precursor to something more big. I'm not sure. It feels like something is in the works, and I just, for whatever reason, regime change is just screaming in my head, you know. Look at everybody in their own country, in America, right now, that are Trump haters. They want to see him gone. They want to see him gone through any means necessary, like if that's what Antifa's thing was, by any means necessary, right? So, you know, and just because it's Canada or America or Australia or UK doesn't mean that there can't be a regime change, you know? I'm not here to say that, you know, I have the, what they've planned or whatever, how they're gonna do it, but think about the regime changes or the color revolutions that we've had in the past. These are outside funded enterprises because for whatever reason, they've got a group with a niche of people inside the country that aren't happy with the way things are going, so, well, we've got to change it. So I don't know whether, you know, how it's going to happen, if it's a civil war, and then, okay, you know, they do some kind of tentative try and for a gun grab or whatever, or some kind of change or control, and then, oh, well, to protect the Americans from themselves, you know, because Trump's not doing the job, you got to oust him and put something else, you know. I mean, look at what happened in the Kennedy years. That was a regime change. That was a regime change. That was a complete switching of direction of wherever, whatever, what have you, you know. He was going in a certain path, you know, he was making certain speeches, and then all of a sudden, that all ended. So, you know, like I said, there's a lot more things that have to come out for me to completely definitively say that, yes, X and Y happened and da-da-da-da-da, because, I mean, right now, the misinformation and the disinformation is, you know, is a campaign, right? So there's a lot of money out there, so there's a lot of things that can be put out to make either side look bad. You know, ha 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 ha, it was a fake, and we put it out, and you guys jumped on it, da-da-da-da-da. So, but I see, I just feel it. I feel a regime change. I feel something that's, something is in the works to change something. You know, I don't have the answer. I wish I did. But it's just a really sad, sad situation. I need more time to really go through it, and so I can make a better video about it, but I just, it's something, you know, look, I hope nothing happens. You know, you get 350, 400 million people down there, you know, and not all of them are bad people. You know, there's bad people everywhere on the planet, so, you know, for everybody to say, oh, the Americans love their guns and stuff, that's just too much of a blanket statement, you know. We've got to think deeper, you got to look deeper, you know. We need more information, we need more information. You know, but of course, and you're not going to get it from the MSM, they're just, they've got their narrative. Oh look, we found a passport. It's Osama bin Laden. You know, I mean, whatever's easy, right? Anyway, it seems to be the case. But, looks like my barefoot running days will be short-lived. Had one, a really beautiful run yesterday. Got new pavement out here, so it's black, absorbs the sunlight. As long as there's sun out, I can run. You know, it doesn't matter if the air is cold. But if the ground is cold, the cold just translates right through, goes all the way up through my knees, and I just can't run. So anyway, another workout, another one in the bucket. I'm dunning, just finishing up with my abs. I wish you all the best, like especially down in America. Like I've got a lot of people I know in America. My dad's wife is American. My good buddy, next door neighbor buddy, that grew up with in Montreal, he's a Texan now. Like he was half American. His mom was American, so he was able to have papers. So he was able to go to work down there. So he's been in Texas, so he's American, you know, and he went through Harvey, and I just, you know, I think we can solve problems if in another manner. But anyway, I'm babbling. I'm just going on. I don't want to see anything bad happen, you know. I mean, it seems to be the case, but bad things happen, you know. So, but anyway, more things will have to come out for me to make a definitive, yeah, it was him. No, it was that. No, it was this, you know. I'm 100% positive it wasn't a hoax. From what I've gathered so far, that people did get shot, people did die. You know, I'm not going so far off that I'm saying that it was a completely staged event and, you know, it was all gunshots on speaker or whatever. So I can't say that. I have to say that it was some sort of event, false flag, blown nut, still, I'm more on the side of a false flag than I am some lone nut. Anyway, peace to you. Take care. Talk to you on the next one.